So, the BOD value of a wastewater feed stream to an activated sludge unit is S0 is equal to 300 mg per liter, and effluent is desired to be S is equal to 30 mg per liter. The feed flow rate is, that is given by F is equal to 2 into 10 raised to the power 7 liter per day. For recycled residue of alpha is equal to 0.5 and steady state biomass concentration of X is equal to 5 gram per liter. Derive the expression and calculate. A. The reactor volume. B. The biomass concentration in recycle. C. Solids residence time. D. Hydraulic residence time. Use quantized equation for growth, which is given by mu is equal to mu max S by KSX, that is the quantized constant, times the biomass concentration plus S. And the kinetic constants mu max is equal to 1.5, the inverse, and YX bar S is equal to 0.5 gram per gram, and KSX is equal to 0.002 gram per gram, and KD is equal to 0.07, the inverse. Okay, first we draw the activated sludge unit. So activated sludge unit, let's assume it has a volume of V and it has an input feed stream, say F, and the initial concentration SO and XO, the biomass concentration. And we take out a exit stream having a volumetric flow rate 1 plus alpha times F, and the biomass concentration to be X, and the substrate concentration, that is the desired effluent concentration, S. And we take it to a concentrator or a settler where the cells would be removed from the effluent, thereby getting a clarified stream, and the cells would be recycled. So the settled cells would be recycled, that is a fraction would be recycled. And the excess would be taken as excess sludge. So this gets mixed with the input stream. So, and the clarified solution is let out, which has a volumetric flow rate of 1 by gamma F, X effluent, and S. And this stream has a combined flow rate of alpha plus gamma F, X recycle, and the substrate concentration S. So the recycled stream has a biomass concentration that we have to find, that is called the XR, and the steady state substrate concentration S, and the volumetric flow rate alpha F. So the input to the reactor is a system under consideration having an input which is the sum of this F and alpha F. So F plus alpha F, this is the initial feed flow rate, and the output, this term, 1 plus alpha times the feed flow rate. So the input has a substrate concentration, this XO times F, this is the biomass in here, plus alpha F XR. And in output, we have the steady state biomass concentration X, so 1 plus alpha FX. So we can write similarly for the substrates SO and S. So writing the substrate balance, substrate in, so here substrate enters as FSO times alpha F S. This is a substrate in, and substrate comes out as 1 plus alpha F times S. 1 plus alpha F times S. Substrate cannot be generated. There is no substrate generation here, and substrate is consumed and cells grows utilizing the substrate. So the growth rate of cell is mu g xv by y x bar s. The cells formed, that is the yield of cells per gram of substrate. And we assume a steady state, so d of sv over dt is equal to 0, so 0, right? So we expand it, so fso plus alpha fs minus fs minus alpha fs minus mu g xv by yx bar s is equal to 0. This term repeats, cancel. So FSO minus FS is equal to mu g xv by yx bar s. We need to find the reactor volume, that is the V. So let's keep V on one side and take all the terms to the other side. So we get F times SO minus S YX bar S by mu G times X. This is the expression for the reactor volume. So let's plug in the data. So V is equal to, the feed flow rate is given as 2 into 10 raised to the power 7 liters per day times the substrate concentration. SO is 300 minus 30 times YX bar S, the kinetic constant of yield is 0.5, divided by mu g. We need to calculate mu g using the quantized equation. So let's calculate mu g. Mu g is equal to mu max 1.5 times the substrate outlet substrate concentration, that is 30, divided by KSX. KS is 0.02 as no unit, and X 5. 5 gram is 5000 plus 30, which is equal to mu g comes around to be 0.346 day inverse. We found the value of mu g. It is 0.346 day inverse times the X. X value is 5 gram per liter. Since these are in mg per liter, so we convert it to 5000 mg per liter. So we have calculated this value, which is equal to 2.7 into 10 raised to the power 9 by 1730, which is equal to 1.56 into 10 to the power 6 liter. So the volume is equal to 1560 meter cube. So we found the reactor volume V. Then we need to find the biomass concentration, solid resistance and hydraulic resistance time. So we know the theta C, that is the solid resistance time, which is equal to 1 over mu net. But mu net is equal to mu G minus KD, where KD is the rate of death, cell death. Since mu net is equal to 0.346, which we have calculated here, minus KD 0.07, which comes around to be 0.276 1 over day. So we can calculate theta C, which is equal to 1 over 0.276. So the value of theta C is equal to 3.621 days. So we found the solid resistance time theta C, and the hydraulic radial resistance time theta H, which is equal to 1 by the dilution rate. D is equal to F by V, so V by F. So we got the volume 1560 meter cube. So 1560 meter cube divided by the feed flow rate, 2 into 10 raised to the power 7 liters. So 2 into 10 raised to the power 7 liter. So 2 into 10 raised to the power 4, where 10 power 3 liter is equal to meter cube. So dividing these two value, we get around theta H as 0.078 days. So we found the hydraulic resistance time theta H 0.078 days. So we are writing the cell balance. So the cells in minus cells out, cells generated minus cell death is equal to the steady state cell, that is d by dt of xv. Since steady state, dx by dt is equal to 0. So by looking at this figure, we can say the cells in is fxo. Plus, we have the recycle steam, that is alpha F XR. This is the input cell in, minus cells out, 1 plus alpha F times X. Cells generated, mu G XV. Cell depth, given by the death rate constant times xv is equal to d by dt of xv. Steady state, RHS equal to 0. So since it's a sterile feed, they haven't given the value of the XO. So we take it to be 0 plus alpha F XR minus FX minus alpha FX plus mu G minus KD is equal to mu net. Mu net times XV is equal to 0. So we rearrange these terms and write in terms of theta C and theta V. So let's take F common. So F times alpha XR minus X minus alpha X is equal to minus mu net XV. Take this term to the denominator. Therefore, 1 by mu net is equal to theta C. So F times theta C into alpha XR minus alpha X is equal to negative X times V. We know theta H is equal to V by F. So divide by F, so we get the theta H on this side. So theta C times, just change the negative sign, so it becomes minus alpha XR plus X plus alpha X is equal to X times theta H. We need to get this value, that is XR. So I can take out X. So theta C times X. So it becomes generally minus alpha XR by X plus 1 plus alpha, which is equal to X times theta H. So we have X on both sides, cancel, LHS, RHS. So we got the expression, say theta H is equal to theta C times 1 plus alpha minus alpha times XR by X. So the value of theta H is equal to 0.078 days. Theta C is equal to 3.621 days. So the unit gets cancelled, and 1 plus the alpha 0.5 recycle ratio minus 0.5 times XR by X. So XR by X, that is 5 gram per liter. Therefore, we get the unit of XR as gram per liter. So 0.078 divided by 3.621 is equal to 0.0215. 1 plus 0.5, 1.5 minus 0.5 by 5, 0.1 XR unit gram per liter. Just interchange. 0.1 times the biomass concentration in recycle is equal to 1.5 minus 0.0215. 1.4785 divided by 0.1 XR, which is equal to 14.785 gram per liter. So we have calculated, say the first A reactor volume, V is equal to 1560 meter cube, and B the biomass concentration in the recycle, which we found XR is equal to 14.785 gram per liter, and C the solid resistance time, that is theta C, which is equal to 1 by mu net 3.621 days, and D the hydraulic residence time theta H, which is equal to 0.078 days. We found all the values. Thank you.